We are thrilled to be here with you this week, the best community in tech. We're here to learn and have fun this week, and the team has put on a great event. And given everything that's going on with AI, we wanted to make it our best yet. You know, I've been at Microsoft for over 30 years and seen a lot of sea changes, and this is easily the biggest one yet in terms of giving people the chance to be more productive, to giving them insights to make better decisions, to fostering their creativity, to giving them tools that enable them to be leaders and change agents to help their organizations transform. It's incredible. We're excited to show stuff. As I said, AI is here for both end users and their productivity and organizations and their transformation. We thought we'd start with the first demos on end user productivity and, in fact, showing you how we all use Copilot and Microsoft every day.
So let me ask a question here of who could I reach out to about a question on OneDrive? And you'll see that it gives me back a great set of answers, Microsoft support, maybe a phone number, a couple of websites I can use. But if you have a Copilot license, you can go over to the work scope. And I'm gonna ask the exact same question. Now, what happened when I switched between work and web is that I changed the context of Copilot. So we are combining the full power of LLM with your Microsoft Graph and M365 apps. So you'll see that this spits out a very different answer. It pulls up my two managers, which is who I go to when I have a question about OneDrive. And they're actually both here today. So if you guys have any questions, I'm going to point you in their direction. Now, Copilot can do more than help me just find the right people. I want to walk you through, you know, something I did this morning. I asked Copilot, can you summarize the most important emails from my manager and then prioritize them? And you'll see, I ran this morning, it says 4:42 a.m., and I got back things that I'm familiar with, my manager asking for help on a script, some bugs he found, but there's this thing called the on-site agenda that he's referencing that I don't know what that is. So I'm gonna continue the chat and actually ask Copilot to find this for me. Oh, it's right there. And I'm gonna ask, what do I need to do here? Now, while Copilot's working, I want to draw your attention to these emails. I have over 35 emails sitting in my inbox from my manager right now. So Copilot did not just give me the five most recent. It gave me the five most important based on my job, what he needs help with, and what our team needs to do. It then stack ranks those five based on the dates in that email so I know what to focus on first. Now, we saw Copilot came back, and it went through that agenda that he was referencing that I wasn't sure of, and it calls out that, okay, it looks like it might be a couple of sessions going on, and I see organize a team event at your house. I have a vague memory of volunteering my house for the team, but thank you, Copilot, for reminding me.
As I mentioned earlier, I am a New York-based employee at a Redmond-based company. We are definitely expanding more and more into other parts of the US, but generally I am the remote participant, and as a result, I often miss a lot of meetings. I usually would have FOMO, but now I have Intelligent Meeting Recap, so I have JOMO, the joy of missing out. It's so good missing meetings. It's the best. I don't think anyone's gonna go to meetings anymore. It's just gonna be webinars for everybody. But we're going to see in this view, I have everything I need to catch up on this very, very important launch update that I have no context on whatsoever. So even though this meeting was an hour long, I of course can zip around the video. I can very quickly see, you know, just specifically the parts of the video that people that I care about said. So, hey, what was Mario's, you know, what did he say during the meeting? We use AI to automatically generate all the topics. So you can see very quickly, oh, I just wanna go to the launch plan or just the press and media part. And we also segment up if there was media that was shared, like the PowerPoint, into little chapters. So if you have nostalgia for your old like DVDs with like the chapters, you can see that here and you can jump around very easily. And then my personal favorite, the ability to see anytime I'm mentioned in the meeting. Very important if people just have this habit of giving you action items when you're not present. And so it's super helpful to see that. And then of course, we have Copilot embedded as well. And so you can see Copilot has actually given me a full set of meeting notes for the meeting. How cool is that?
Now, I'm gonna take you through a whistle-stop tour of all of the new SharePoint UX features. I'm excited to do all of these pieces and show you just a little bit about what you can experience. There is so much innovation that is packed up into this page. First off, custom fonts. Woo! Yes! Flexible layouts are an important part of this too. We've got section backgrounds, and then of course we've got things like image cutouts. All of those coolest styles of the web are right there at your fingertips. Now, of course, when you're authoring here, we want to make it easier for you to do that. So flexible layouts, they let you control both the look, the style, and the feel of everything that's going on inside of your page. Design Ideas makes it easy for me to go from the ordinary to the extraordinary in a snap, and makes it simple for me to collaborate directly here inside of a page with other people who are working on the same page at the same time. It's really incredible to see the dozens and dozens of things that we have announced over the last year and be able to see dozens and dozens more that are on our roadmap. Pumped for the new SharePoint experience. Yes! So, I think so. Now, you might be going, hey, well, that's pretty amazing, right? I have all of this great content out here. I'm able to see very quickly the beautiful image and engaging content that SharePoint's making for me. How can it get better? Well, just like with OneDrive, we're going to look at how we're going to supercharge all of this with Copilot inside of SharePoint. I'm going to start off in this case. You can see a page template. That page template is going to help me to take away one of the jobs that I hate doing the most, which is my monthly status update. Right? Well, that monthly status update, in this case, it's about a construction area here. I've got to pull out some quotes from the general manager and think about how I can use all of the information I already have. I can, of course, pick directly here from Word a file that I've already created. I don't have to go create something new. And you can see here that Copilot has become my companion web designer. It has taken a great start of this page. It's helped me to see the images, pulled out the quotes that I need. And of course, Copilot can even help me to take it to the next level by rewriting some of the content that's directly in here. So I get to make my modifications easily here too. I'm really, really excited about what we're doing here with Copilot in SharePoint, and I hope that you're inspired by all of this too.
There's really one word that summarizes what we're trying to do at Microsoft, which is empower people. And I hope you see how we're trying to empower every person in every organization. And we're so grateful that you're here with us today, and you've been on that empowerment journey with us to the cloud, through the pandemic with hybrid, and now in the early stages of AI. We are so grateful and excited to learn with each and every one of you. Thank you so much for all your support.